So now we'll learn about a very important topic, vectors, okay? Fine. So vectors also is a part of the mathematical tools that we need for, you know, doing and solving the questions later on also, okay? Fine. So until now we have seen that there are physical quantities, they can be standard or the fundamental physical quantities, or they can be derived physical quantities from the standard physical quantities, okay? So we have seen that there are physical quantities. It can be fundamental, it can be derived. It can be fundamental physical quantity, or it can be derived from the fundamental physical quantity, right? This is what we have seen until now, okay? Correct. Now, these fundamental physical quantities, whether derived or fundamental, these physical quantities, whether derived or fundamental, again, are of two types, okay? They are of two types, okay? They can be scalars or they can be vectors, okay? They can be vectors, okay? Now, what is the difference? The difference is that the scalars, the physical quantities that are scalars in nature, okay, you only need magnitude to define them. Magnitude means what? Quantity. For example, mass. Magnitude means quantity, amount of something, okay? So, what is the meaning of magnitude? Is amount, quantity. For example, I give the example of mass, okay? Mass is a scalar physical quantity. That means, you only need magnitude. You just say that, okay, 5 kilograms, 10 kilograms of mass, that is enough to define the mass of something, okay? Vectors, they have magnitude as well as direction, okay? To completely define a vector, you need to give two information about the vector physical quantity, okay? The magnitude, how much, and the direction of that physical quantity. For example, I'll give displacement. Displacement is a vector quantity, vector physical quantity. You have to say, like, I am here right now, okay? Now, if I say my displacement is 5 meters, okay? Now, this 5 is quantity, the magnitude part of the vector, okay? But is that enough? Is that sufficient to define and say that, okay, this is the displacement? No. I have to say that in which direction? In this direction. Which direction? 30 degree, 40 degree, where? So you have to say, specify a direction for the vector, okay? So you have to, along with the magnitude, you have to say the direction also. Magnitude plus direction. Magnitude and direction, correct? Defines it completely, whereas mass, if you say 5 kilogram in north direction, that doesn't mean anything, okay? So, you only need magnitude and it is fully defined, correct? So, that is the basic idea of scalars and vectors, okay? I give more example. If I want to give more example, what I can say? Mass, speed, time, temperature. These are a few examples of scalar quantities. Mass, you don't need to give any direction. Speed, you don't need to give any direction. Time, 10 seconds, 5 seconds, that is just quantity. There is no direction associated with the quantity. Temperature, 10 degrees Celsius or Kelvin. Okay, you don't need to specify a direction. Some examples of vector quantities, if I give. So, velocity. Okay, velocity is, you know, speed plus direction, speed of something in some particular direction, if I specify, then speed plus direction together is velocity, okay? So velocity, acceleration, momentum, force, electric field, magnetic field. These are all vector quantities, okay? You have to specify what is the magnitude of force and what is the direction the force is being applied in, okay? This direction, you have to specify a direction of all these vector quantities, okay? That is the idea of vector quantity, okay? So now, what is we are going to learn in the chapter? So, scalars, suppose you have to add two scalars, okay? Let's say there is a balance, a weighing balance here, okay? Let's say. Now, if you add 2 kilogram of mass, 2 kilogram of something, 2 kg, okay? And then you add 5 kilogram more. If you add 5 kg of something more, so what is the total mass then? 2 plus 5, 7, right? 7. I simply add them like scalars, 2 plus 5, like simple numbers, okay? 2 kilogram plus 5 kilogram is 7 kilogram, okay? There is nothing complicated, but the same you cannot be doing with the vectors. I'll give you an example. Suppose displacement is a vector quantity. See, displacement also is a vector quantity. So, displacement is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity. So, suppose I gave you here 2 kilogram is one mass and 5 kilogram is another mass. To add them, you have to simply say 2 plus 5, 7 kilogram is the total mass. Correct? Now, I give you two displacements. Okay. Suppose you were standing here initially, then first displacement was here, okay? This is, I denote a vector like this, okay? A vector is denoted by an arrow, okay? Suppose this is the first displacement. You displaced yourself by 5 meter in this particular direction where the arrow is pointing, okay? 5 meters, okay? This was the displacement number 1. Let's say call it R1 vector. This is how we denote a vector, R1. Any vector quantity you denote by an arrow on the top of it, or in the books you can find that they are written in bold letters, okay? So R1 with magnitude 5 meter is what the magnitude of the displacement, and the direction the arrow is pointing is the direction of the vector, okay? So there are two components of this vector, R1 vector 5 meter in this particular direction. It may be anything, 30 degree, 40 degree, whatever it is. I have taken it at some random angle, okay? This is R1 vector, okay? First displacement. And then another displacement is, let's say, like this. This is R2 vector. Let's say this length is, let's say, 7 meters in this direction, okay? That arrow is pointing in some particular direction. I have chosen randomly. Can I say the total displacement is 7 plus 5 is equal to 12 meters? No. The total displacement is what? The total displacement, as you can see, starting from the beginning, this is the displacement ultimately, no? He was here initially at the point A and he is ultimately at the point B. So, this length AB is the ultimate displacement, isn't it? Maybe he went to this point C first, from A to C and then C to B, but AC plus CB means AB is the net magnitude of the displacement. So, I just can't simply say the magnitude of the displacement is 5 plus 7 is equal to 12. No. So, whatever, depending on these angles, depending on the geometry, you can find out using mathematics, you can find out, okay, what is the length of AB going to be, okay? That we'll see how to find out and all. But understand what we are going to learn actually, okay? So, the conclusion here is that there is a specific way we deal with vectors, okay? There is a rule we deal with vectors. Vectors has its own algebra, how to add vectors, how to subtract vectors, how to multiply them, what is the significance of मल्टीप्लाइंग दें, व्हाट इज द फिजिकल इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ सम, व्हाट इज द फिजिकल इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ मल्टीप्लाइंग टू वेक्टर्स एंड ऑल्सो द मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ वेक्टर्स वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ, ओके, एंड व्हाट इज द व्हाट डज इट सिग्निफाई एक्चुअली ऑन ग्राउंड, ओके, एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ वेक्टर्स. दिस इज वन थिंग. एंड द अदर थिंग इज लाइक आई सेड that all these physical quantities are vector quantities, right? They are vector physical quantities that are vector. And these are the things, these are the physical quantities. We know that in physics, we have to study a lot of physical quantities, right? These are the things we'll be learning in the subsequent chapter, right? So we know how to deal with them, how to, you know, do the operations, whatever subtraction or whatever multiplication, addition. So we know the rule of the game. We must be knowing the rule of the game. Then only we can deal with them, right? So in this vectors chapter, we are going to learn that rule of the game, okay? So it is very important because the same thing you have to do in all the chapters. Wherever these physical quantities come, you should be knowing how to deal, right?